We're not actors or TV personalities. We're just a couple of guys who want to show you how to restore your car. Sometimes we mess up. Sometimes we consult the pros. It's never a problem. It's always a project.
Coming up on Autorestomod, Jeff lays carpet. Vinny doesn't give a fuck. Man, you guys, I swear.
Order a bunch of parts to get ready for the car show this weekend?
And I got a hot deal, too.
You think? Think again.
Oh, man.
Tired of back orders? You need NPD. With four strategically located superstores, orders are shipped direct to your door within 1 to 3 business days. National Parts Depot has quality restoration parts for Ford Truck, Mustang, Camaro, Chevelle, and Firebird. For your free catalog, visit NPD online or call toll-free.
Previously on Autorestomod.
67. Isn't that a 22-gallon tank?
Yes, it is.
I thought we decided that we weren't going to do that because we already established our bladder is going to need emptied before that needs filled on a road trip.
Now, you'll notice there's this green foam all around the perimeter of the gas tank, and I did that for a reason. Since we're going to be putting carpet in here, I want to have this area filled up. Ah, I see that you have the ACC carpet set from NPD here.
Oh, I thought it was just a bunch of carpet scraps. I was confused for a second.
It's not carpet scraps. This is actually the aftermarket carpet set that NPD offers from the guys at ACC if you wanted to go in and do a modified look in your car. Because if you're not doing a modified look, you're going to be using a plastic piece like I've got here in place of that. In other words, this would just be in the trunk and that's all you would do. And it would just be the stock paint and everything back there and kind of trashy looking. If you want to upgrade to a modified look, you go with the ACC carpet set.
The pocket on the wheel cover. Plus you put your directions, your jacking points and all
that's,
that.
That's not what that's for.
Oh.
But anyway, that's for what we're doing. That might make a really good idea because we're not probably going to be using that. So anyway, with the 22-gallon tank, we're going to have to do some things different.
Wait a minute. You said there weren't any modifications for putting the 22-gallon tank in.
There aren't for putting the tank in the car.
But the stock for modifying carpet set.
Oh man, all bets are off. You're in the wind at that point because what happens is when you put the 22-gallon tank in, you raise the thing up about 2.5 inches off the stock position for the 16-gallon tank, which is flat on the top.
I see.
That's why we put the foam in last time. So now nothing fits like it did before because all this stuff is custom cut to a 16-gallon tank configuration.
Gotcha. And this looks a little wide for that Space Saver spare.
Yeah, well, you know, we can't put the stock tire or the tires that we've got on there.
They're not fitting in the trunk.
They won't go in the trunk. So we have to do something like a Space Saver spare, and it'll just give us a little bit more room in there. So we'll have to actually reduce the size of that as well.
I see.
So what I'm actually going to do now is I'm going to use the plastic piece that's the stock style stuff, that's the cheap one from National Parts Depot, to show the guys how to make a buck.
You'll make a buck with that?
No, not that kind of buck.
Show me how to make a buck.
A template.
Oh.
Yes.
That kind of buck.
Yeah, well, you can call it a buck or a template. Never mind. I'm going to go work on this.
Yeah, we got stuff to do.
So, why did we buy a plastic mat to go in the car when we're not going to be using it at all? Well, there's a good reason for that. Why I bought this from National Parts Depot was I wanted to have a buck for me to build the carpet setup for this car out of, because, as I said before, you can't get a carpet set from the guys at ACC that's already pre-cut for a 22-gallon tank in an early Mustang. So what you're going to have to do is make your own. Now, if you buy a mat like this one, and this is the really cheap one that NPD sells, it's not the really nice Concours one, this will give you a pretty good idea of exactly how the layout should be. Now, you can go in and base your mat off of this opening here that's already pre-cut in the mat for the gas tank filler neck. You start from there and move out and forward, and you do your cuts from that point. You'll notice that I've got a big no symbol over here. That no symbol is actually so that I know not to make this split cut whenever I'm setting up the carpet set. And you'll notice I've already gone in and started making some of the cuts in this mat so that I'll know how to lay this out. This is another cut that we're going to be making going across here. The other thing we did with this mat is, because we're not worried about this mat, we cut our hole for the spare tire mount in the mat itself. That way, we've got this here already, and we can go and put it in the carpet in a nicer cut configuration. Not that anybody's going to see it, because if you had a stock spare in there, you're not going to see it, simply because the spare will be over the top of it if your car has a spare in it, because I see a lot of these cars that don't, and I really don't understand why. Okay, you can see a lot of red lines on here, and that's basically so that we know how to make our cuts. I want to make one quick point. This line right here that you see on here that we've already gone in and cut while we had it in the car is actually straight when it's in the car. So that tells you why it's a good idea to have some kind of buck that you can set in there so that you can make your marks on it and then pull it out and make your cuts. Because this line and both this line over here are straight cuts inside the car. But because of the pull down in these two sections here and here, you end up with it turning it so that those become straight. Little things like that can bite you in the rear end if you're not careful. But what I'm also going to do is I'm going to go in and make a few more straight lines on here so that I'm sure about my positioning, because this right here is actually angled just a little bit. Now you'll notice that I've taken where I had the rough line in there before, I've gone in and straightened that up. And I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. Now the reason I'm going to cut these tabs off on the end that would normally be there is because we're going to be putting some guards up inside, and on the driver's side, that's where our subwoofer goes and our tire goes over here. So we're going to have to make some modifications to the kit that you get from National Parts Depot through ACC for the trunk, on top of the modifications we're already having to make for the 22-gallon tank. All right, I'm finishing this up here, and then we're going to take it after I get this cut made, do one final test fit with the plastic, just to make sure we got it, and then we're going to do our carpet. Okay, so I've got my carpet set up underneath our pad. Now the pad is flipped over because this is exactly how we sat it set in the car. So the pattern side is facing the back of the carpet, which will have our carpet setting correctly when we put it inside the car. Another thing I wanted to go over is this. These only come in, I think, 52-inch widths. So you're not going to be able to go all the way over to the inside of the wheel wells with this. If you were going to take these all the way out to the inside of the fenders, you're going to need to get some carpet tape like you would use in household carpet and extend those out that way. We're going to be putting panels in, so that's not really going to be an issue for us. Now, the other thing I wanted to say is this. You could go the other way, but then your carpet line would be laying this way inside of the car when all the rest of your carpet typically goes horizontally. So you're going to have to keep that in your mind whenever you're working on this kind of a carpet setup. Now I'm going to go in and start making my marks on these to make our cuts. Whenever you're doing these, what I'm going to want to do is I'm going to go out beyond where I've actually marked a little bit so that I've got some wiggle room with my carpet cuts. I'd rather have too much than not enough. I can always cut this off inside the car. I dang sure can't put it back on. Keep these two together to move them forward and go ahead and make the rest of my marks. Now when you're doing your cuts, I recommend a really good set of scissors. These are Fiskars, and they're sewing scissors, and quite frankly, I wouldn't do this with anything else because they just cut nicer than most every other scissor I've ever worked with. I don't get any money from Fiskars, but I'm telling you, if you don't buy them, you're not going to be happy with your cut work. Now I'm going to go ahead and make all my cuts here, and I'm going to trial fit this. Again, most of my cut lines are bigger than they need to be so that I can go in and change those and cut them down if I need to. I'm always a big proponent of measuring twice and cutting once. Now, I'm making cuts, but they're larger than they need to be. If you're working in an upholstery shop doing this kind of stuff, you would have a much larger table than what we're working with here. It would be a big, open, long table about 10 foot across, because you need the room to do this kind of stuff. Final thing is the gas filler neck. This is your lineup point on the carpet, at least on a Mustang. If you don't have a gas filler neck in the floor, you might want to pick another point for lineup. Okay, now I'm going to go in and make my cut for the spare tire hook. And I'm going to use a utility knife to make this cut because trying to do that with a pair of scissors is kind of a pain in the rear. And I have a piece of wood under here so I don't cut through my tablecloth and my table. Don't ask me how I know that that can happen. Okay, got my cut made. Let's do a test fit. And we want our carpet to lay flat. So what I've done is I've taken the magnetic side material, put it on top of the gas tank with the magnetic side down and the white side up. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna lay this in sections. I'm gonna do this quarter, then this quarter, and then I'm gonna fold this over so that it sticks down, and then do the front half of the gas tank so that we're all completely glued down on the center section. That way, when we lay this in, it'll lay nice and flat. Not so worried about the two side panel sections at this point because eventually there'll be a subwoofer over here and there'll be a tire on the other side, so those shouldn't be as problematic as this big field of carpet is going to be in the middle here. This will allow you to get this to lay down really, really flat and really sweet. You want to shake up your adhesive and basically just go in and glue. Now I've put down some templates in here to soak up any of the adhesive that might go outside of the boundaries, so to speak. And I've also put a spare piece of carpet inside the hole for the gas filler. Now honestly, what I would really recommend you doing with this is spraying this stuff outdoors if you can, but the problem we're running into is that outside today has been kind of wet, and also that we don't have a way to get the thing back in here if we actually go outside with it. This product is fairly controllable, so you can get pretty tight with these edges. Okay, now I'm gonna let that sit for a little bit and go in and spray the other side. All right, we've let this sit up for a little bit, and I'm gonna take the carpet and roll it back on itself, trying to keep it pretty flat, because once this sticks down, hopefully it'll stick pretty tight. I'm just gonna put it back down in position for a little bit, let that half set up. But you can already see that we've got a really nice lay to the carpet now that was not there before. We actually had some bunching down here in this section here. Not there now. You could almost not glue this back half that we got up here, and part of me would almost be tempted not to, but might as well go ahead and do it right if we're gonna do it. So I'll let that dry for a little bit, then I'm gonna come back in and stick that front half.
So if you're doing a concourse car, you wanna make sure that this back panel gets painted. Now we're doing a custom carpet set, so we weren't too worried about it. And most of these pieces right from the Auto Custom carpets that will fit right in with little or no modification. And also be sure you have the right piece. They are different between the driver's side and passenger side. The passenger side is just a little bit smaller. And this basically just rolls in. A little friction holds that in place. Now we've got the bucket covers. These bucket covers are directional also. So you want to make sure you've got the short Velcroed piece facing the inside of the car and no Velcro goes up on the top. Working it a little bit until you get it so that you're comfortable with it and it looks good. Now we have the filler neck cover. Now the stock cut from Auto Custom Carpets is a little bit larger than what we need, and that's because we went to the 22-gallon tank, which required a different filler neck tube. So we were able just to fold that over a little bit. Make sure you have this piece centered. Then you can just fold it over. And now we may end up cutting this to make it match a little bit better, but if it was a stock application, it would fit really well. Next, Jeff's gonna show you how to do these side panel pieces, because we are gonna have to trim the carpet just a little bit.
Whee! All right, so the side trim panels that we've got here on the table, you don't have to do what I'm fixing to do here. This is strictly if you wanna customize these. A long time ago when I was working on this car, way back when I first got it, I actually made a set of these before they were available from the guys at ACC. This is the one that I did with what I was planning on doing in the trunk on the car, so I'm going to use this one to modify the ACC part we have here on the table just so it matches what I want to do. Again, this would work just fine if you wanted to go with the stock configuration with the aftermarket part. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to turn this over and make my markings on the back side of it for where it needs to sit. Now, on these, this is where your wheel well sits. This is the wheel well position on the ACC part. So I'm going to pull that and line up my baseline, which this is the floor, and this is up inside the roof area. So it looks like I'm going to probably have to go in and maybe make a little bit of a cut on the ACC piece here. And for show, I'm going to have to do some cutting on this end. Now, I want to make sure on this, when I set this up, that I give myself a little bit of extra room, because on the other side I did not, and I'm going to have to go in and make some modifications to it in order to make it look right. So I'm going to go in and kind of add a little bit of meat to this before I start making my cuts. Boy, those art classes sure paid off. Now, what we'll do with this piece down here on the bottom after we make our cuts with this is this will fold up underneath our carpet. So that's kind of how I find this laying the best with what I want to do with it. Okay, now I'm going to use a utility knife and cut this. Because the carpet is going to be facing out, you're not going to really have a problem with needing these cuts to be super duper nice. In other words, you don't really necessarily need to use a ruler to make your cuts here, but a good sharp utility knife is always a good one. Hey Vinny, bring me that heat gun, man.
Bring in the heat.
Sometimes I don't know about you. Thank you, Vinny. I appreciate the help. All right, now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you a way to serge the edge on your carpet using a heat gun. And what you're just trying to do is to get these carpet edges here to kind of lose that little nappiness that they've got going on right there. And you're just basically balling up those edges. Any long stragglers, you'll want to go in and cut those off. Now, what we're going to do is take this over and do a test fit and make sure this is going to work. Hopefully I cut this right. And I'm going to... Vince... What in the world? Anyway, what we're gonna do now is we're gonna do the test fit on this. I'm gonna slide this up in, and it actually goes up in between this panel and an inside brace that's over here in the back that's really hard for us to show you. I may be able to get that later. And it's about where it's gonna sit. Now, what we will do eventually is pull the carpet out from underneath here. This carpet will lay in on top of this piece here, and I'm actually going to put some of the magnetic side material on the bottom of this so it would sit in place if I were actually going to use this piece. I'm not. We're going to be putting a subwoofer in here, and the subwoofer is going to literally use up 99% of the room on this side of the car. But the fit is actually pretty good. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to use the magnetic side material to do the door on the fold-down section of this car with the carpet pieces that come with the ACC kit. Okay, now I've got my trim panel piece that goes in the door for the fold-down section on the 67. What I'm going to do is I'm going to mark out the size of the magnetic side material that I need here with my Sharpie marker, and then cut this out a little smaller than the actual section. And when you're doing this, you want to make sure, when you're using magnetic side material, always make sure that the white side or the colored side is facing the backing of the carpet, and that the magnetic side, which is kind of a gray color, is actually facing toward the metal section that you're going to be laying it to. So now what I'm going to do is take my scissors and cut this out, and then we'll take some trim adhesive and put these two pieces together. I don't mind this being a little small, because where this is actually magnetizing to is not even out at these borders. I'm just giving it a big flat area like this to give it a little bit more meat so that it will actually kind of stand up, if you will, a little bit better. And I may have to go in and retrim this. I'm just kind of knocking this back a little bit to make sure it's inside. That's going to fit nice. I'm going to probably come in and cut this off, but I'm going to go in and now use some trim adhesive to put these two pieces together.
Well, this carpet on the magnet really came out nice. Watch that. That's perfect. Okay, maybe it's not perfect, but let's face it. No matter how perfect I get it, Jeff's going to come in behind me and tweak it to his taste anyways. He's a little anal about those things in his car. Now, we have another trim piece that we just made. This wasn't part of the ACC kit. We just took a little bit of ABS plastic, and we put some Velcro on it. Now, make sure the hook side are on the side where you're going to put the piece. That way it doesn't stick to your carpet if you drop it. It's just a little easier that way. And all we're doing with this piece is just covering up the ugly a little. And that'll fit in there like so. Notice we have the hooks up here. And one other thing we can do, and we've already done that on here, is we put a little piece of carpet in there and we've painted that edge. Without the paint on there, it would have looked kind of brown or just a little light color. Now, if you're doing a different color besides black, you'll still want to paint that edge. You just want to make sure you use a color that matches your carpet. Yep, there just wasn't any factory piece to cover that up or any piece available. So we just made our own. And the ABS is really readily available on the internet. We got ours from a store that supplies speaker components. And if you look at the other side, you can see how it would have looked without that trim piece. And if you were doing a concourse restore, well, you wouldn't have that trim piece on there because Ford didn't give you one.
Got the door done, and it looks like crap. What? Oh my. The way I can leave that, that's awful. It even has it upside down and backwards. Well, I have to say, Vinny, it's actually turned out pretty darn nice so far. There's a couple things I still want to do.
That's a lot of work, though, for an extra 42 pounds of traction.
Always worth it. Anytime I can get more traction in the back of one of these cars, I'm digging it. Carpet's got to weigh a little bit, so we may be actually at 43. I'm going to give it 43. With a magnet and everything, maybe 43. Maybe the magnet will actually hold it to the ground a little bit better, kind of like a slot car. But never mind. But anyway, there's a couple things I want to do. I want to get some corner pieces sewn. We can't do that here. We don't have the facility to do it, but I've got some guys I know here in town that run an upholstery shop, so we're going to get those corner pieces made, get them serge edged so that they'll sit really nice in that corner. But there's no way to really show that. This basically just gives you the idea that this is what you can do to make a trunk look really nice. And I have to say that I'm pretty impressed with the way this turned out.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, glad we had the JTG laying around to glue that carpet down to the magnet.
It's not JTG, it's 3M weather strip glue.
JTG.
Kill
Watch
you
next time on Autorestomod!